ready.
Okay.
So, a very real good morning to all of you. My dear friends of Chandragupt Institute of Management, Patna, the batch of yeah. So now we are going to talk about, in my opinion, the possible, probable, ultimate standards of ethics. There are hundreds of books on ethics. There are hundreds of talking going on about ethics all over the world, not only in management institutes, various avenues, including inside the temples and churches and related places. Everybody knows what is ethics, it seems to be. There are sort of values, morals, principles and so on and so forth. Despite all this, despite the ideas of the great thinkers and philosophers about ethics, I am going to tell you a much greater level of possibility of understanding the dynamics of ethics and imbibing the spirit of real ethics. I say this as ultimate because my model is what is ultimate in this world. What is ultimate?
God.
Death. Oh, wonderful. Even on behalf of God, in his religion, there are principles of ethics and morals. Okay, in that sense, that is, of course, ultimate. I meant a little down. Yes, please.
The life. Ultimate life.
Okay, so what I am going to use is, or rather, I use the concept of ethics. Ultimate in the sense that I am using the nature processes model. All of you did really wonderful in quickly identifying, of course to my surprise, the core factors involved in the process by looking at, not even looking at, by thinking about the process of
feeling.
And one of you, or some of you, even had the great understanding about the greatest approach to tea making, called tea ceremony, rather chanoyu, chanoyu in Japanese language, for tea ceremony. So looking at the model of nature process, therefore I call it ultimate, we are going to derive the principles of ultimate ethics. Okay. So let us look at the opening of a flower, the blooming of a tree, or even the formation of a cup of tea. You remember, Jyoti, that he said the tea is finally formed not by the work of the human being.
Energy.
But by the nature process. What you can do ultimately is only to put all these things and place it in a setting, and the tea forms there by the work of the nature. So by my observations and interactions with the nature process, I have identified five core principles, or rather the ethics of the nature process. The fundamental ways of happenings in things and entities and phenomena in the nature. And why I say it is ultimate is because we too are entities of the nature. Agree?
Yes.
Though we have a dress, though we talk languages, though we drive Mercedes-Benz and BMWs and Lamborghinis and Lexus and travel in modern aircrafts and drive modern bikes and press the buttons of absolutely state of that mobiles and laptops, still we have to sit down and eat. Still we have to depend upon the circulation system and the digestive system and the muscular system and the central nervous system of this very creature, this very entity formed by the nature process. Then why not we follow the principles of nature process? That is my logic. That is why I said that despite the great philosophers from the Socrates and Plato and Aristotle and all those wonderful geniuses in the West and Patanjali's and Vyasas and great geniuses who created Upanishads, I say this is little laterally different. So the principles I have identified, quickly, I'm sure I can make you say all these things. But because we are making a video to show to the world that this is the kind of information being delivered to the students in Chandragupt Institute of Management, Patna, we are sort of concisely talking about it. Instead of my making you discover the principles of nature process, which can be the principles of this, I am just telling it in a short time, okay? It's all very simple because nature process are simple. So as I told you, observe the opening of the flower, observing the way the tea is formed in the kettle, observing the way a cat is jumping from here to there just by a look, observing the ways in which the birds are building that marvelous nest which can withstand the movements of the branches in the winds of the mountains. I have identified five core principles of nature. That is, not in the order, let us talk to begin with. I tell you all the five. They are correct or correctness, complete or completeness, firm or firmness, elegant or elegance, and finally, Taoic, meaning in good tuning. So once again, to talk about it in a comfortable way, what I call firm, correct, complete, elegance and Taoic. Five principles. Remember? The firmness. Let us say, the firm, I should take a simple example, the firm fixing of the parts of a car. All the parts are there. Piston and cylinder and gearbox and crankshaft and steering and all these things, if they are not firmly fixed, okay. The firm fixing of the muscles and the body systems, the firm fixing of the legs on the plank of that makes a table, the firmness in the stand of a cat, which even sometimes a human being cannot face. The firmness is just a word, you can change with some other words. The firm conviction of every other entity in the world to somehow survive despite all kinds of blocks and problems and threats, undefeated. Revealed even in a small plant. If a small plant is near a big tree, it will see that somehow it will turn around and grow like this. The firm conviction. The firm beliefs, the firm principles of the human level. The firm, do you understand that aspect called firmness? That as we call, as we use in that well-known English action, a rose is a rose is a rose. A rose can only be a rose. It's very firm in its roseness. Whether it is in the garden of a palace or if it is happening to go on the side of a highway, whether it is in the hair of a beautiful girl, or whether it is in the hand of a beggar, it is a rose, right? Its roseness is firmly maintained. A rose will not say, I will not grow that much because I am in a filthy place. A rose will not say, because I am taken care of, I am in the hand of an ugly person, therefore I will not bloom that much because it is not okay. Because a rose can only be a rose. A cat is a cat is a cat. So we can quickly think whether a human being is a human being is a human being. So what is, if roseness is the roseness of a rose, what would be the humanness or human beingness of a human being? So these are all questions we can think of in the context of firmness. Understood? Okay. Firm. The first principle of nature process. Everything in the nature. Every entity in the nature, from the amoeba, the smallest protozoa of an amoeba, to a frog, to a fish, to a snake, to a goat, to a lion, to a tiger, to a cat, to a dog, huge plants and all those things. Okay? Second is correctness. Firm and correct. Is there any incorrect thing in the nature? Can you identify one thing in the nature which is incorrect? Can you say yes or no?
No.
The correct placing of the twigs that form the nest of a bird.
Sir,
I have wandered around the mountainous forest, but I have not come across a nest fallen on the ground. I mean a fresh nest, an old nest we can see. Despite it is moving heavily in the winds. It's absolutely correct to place it. Which even now the great engineers in the world are researching on how to have a correct placement of the levers and fulcrums and things like that.
Like we are destroying nature, like it is happening.
That's a beautiful point. We can go on discussing n number of details of human life based on these five principles. As I told you before, because it is a recording session, and people in the world may not be that patient to see through our video on discussing a very highly intellectual item. You are just constraining it into something like 30 minutes. I am just talking out the principles, okay? Followed by this, we can have a discussion, and then you will take an oath on behalf of this core principles of the nature. So, firm, correct, and happy. So, you mean to say that is against correctness? That we will discuss later. No. That is from the perception of the human being that tsunami is dangerous, storm is dangerous. They are all process parts of the nature. It happens correctly, that's all. Okay. So, that we will actually discuss later.